Welcome to this Mass Christian Burial for Jim Burchell. We invite you to stand and join your host in song. 394, the music is due to Ryan Moore, 394. Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and to show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Jim, whom you called to journey to you, and since he hopes and believes in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in his everlasting joys. For our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
The attainment of old age. He who pleased God was loved. He who lived among sinners was transported, snatched away, lest wickedness pervert his mind, or deceit beguile his soul. For the witchery of paltry things obscures what is right, and the whirl of desire transforms the innocent mind. Having become perfect in a short while, he reached the fullness of a long career, for his soul was pleasing to the Lord. Therefore, he sped them out of the midst of wickedness, but the people saw and did not understand, nor did they take this into account, the word of the Lord. Please respond, the Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil, for you are at my side, with your rod and your staff that give me courage. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. Only goodness and kindness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, those who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive a spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you received a spirit of adoption through which we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit itself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs. Heirs of God and joint heirs with Christ, if only we suffer with him, so that we may also be glorified with him. I consider that the sufferings of this present time are as nothing compared with the glory to be revealed for us. For creation awaits with eager expectation the revelation of the children of God. For creation was made subject to futility, not of its own accord, but because of the one who subjected it, in hope that creation itself would be set free from slavery to corruption and share in the glorious freedom of the children of God. We know that all creation is groaning in labor pains even until now. And not only that, but we ourselves, who have the first fruits of the Spirit, we also groan within ourselves as we wait for adoption, the redemption of our bodies, the word of the Lord.
All things have been handed over to me by my Father, No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy, and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
First, you as sisters, and then extended family, and extended friends of Jim, my deepest sympathy. And I know from the inside out, the grief process is hard, and words so often fall short. And I'm more profoundly aware of that today than I perhaps some other times in my life. And unfortunately, I didn't get to know Jim, but I have a feeling I would like him. Of course, I like almost everyone, but you have to really be a putz in order for me not to like somebody. But Jim, the simpleness of his life, how so often we might overlook beauty of that simple life. And see, we too often, and I think most of us are here, make life more difficult than it ought to be. And we don't come to the Lord and come and find His rest and His peace because I can do it on my own. And yet, when we turn to the Gospel, when we look at the readings, and especially these readings that have been selected, we know that that's not true. The Lord tells us in today's Gospel, come to me and rest, you who are heavily burdened, and take my yoke upon you, and learn from me. It always sounds so odd, and to our ears perhaps, if we're tired, to take a yoke upon us. A yoke is an item of work. And yet, that's precisely what the Lord invites us to do, is to take a yoke, not a yoke of slavery and a burden, but a yoke that is well fitted to us, and that the Lord Himself is carrying with us. And so while so often this Gospel passage, we use it at the anointing of the sick, and it's one of the options for funeral as well, we think it's the one who is deceased or one who is struggling with his or her mortality, that's the one to come to rest. But it's also for those who are left behind. Those who are caring for the one who is deceased or the one who is in distress. It's you too. Come to the Lord and rest. You can't carry this burden of grief on your own. You have to have Christ. And Christ, when we do come to Him, reveals the Father to us because He desires to do so. He desires to show us the Father. If you think about any child who's proud of his father, what does that child do? Every chance a child gets, this is my daddy. Christ does that. Not on a child likeness, a child dishness, but child likeness. And invites us to that same child likeness. And time and again we hear that in scriptures. And even today in this second reading, that we are children of God. Children. Again, not to be childish, but to know that we have a relationship with God the Father. And the Spirit witnesses that relationship as we cry out, Abba. If you were kind of taken aback by saying, Christ saying, this is my daddy, that's the best translation for the Abba, daddy. It's a term of affection. And if we understand this relationship that Christ invites us to have with His Father, all creation waits with eager expectation. The trick is, though, we fill our minds with so much stuff, and that's today's first reading, the witchery of paltry things, the trickery that the lower things so often do. They beguile us, like a raven looking at a precious stone,
is beguiled by it and just wants the shiny object. And it will do anything for that shiny object, even if that shiny object is going to lead to its peril. But rather, recalled in wisdom to hold on to what endures, what's most important. As I heard a little bit about Jim's life, I know he must have found family important. He must have found his, again, even in that simplicity, the little things of life, the little joys, the little comforts, as important. The older and the more complicated, complex we get, the more we need somebody like Jim in our life. I know it wasn't Down syndrome that afflicted him, but yesterday was, I believe, National Down Syndrome Awareness Day. I found myself reflecting throughout the day of some of the past parishioners and current parishioners I have that either have a Down syndrome child or brother or sister or are themselves. And I almost cry for joy because they bring such joy. Because they understand they can't do it on their own. And they take joy in being able to come to the Lord and say, "Here I am." Perhaps Jim was a little bit more complicated than that, but how beautiful it is when we have that courage to know that the Lord is the one who gives us rest. For us who mourn, who are saying goodbye, to know that it's okay to say I'm not okay. It's okay to say I can't carry this alone. But it is also our invitation to know Christ invites us to share his yoke. And not in a spirit of slavery, rather in a spirit of adoption. The adoption that gives us hope, joy, peace, happiness, the ability to suffer long, because we know in the end it's not going to be long. With confidence in God's love, we present Him all of our petitions.
In baptism, Jim received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Our brother Jim was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us and await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many people die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord,
those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The family and friends of Jim seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain, dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many struggle with faith or are no longer practicing. May they come to experience the love of God and return to the practice of the faith. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
The Lord calls many to follow as priests and religious. May their labors lead many to heaven. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We are your Son's coming, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
God and Father, we ask you to hear and answer all these prayers. Together, Jim, to yourself, we give rest and peace in your kingdom, and to be with us, together us too. We ask this in Christ's Lord, forever and ever.
Please join us singing number 437, On Eagle's Wings.
Life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that with the rising of the sun to its setting, pure sacrifice may be offered to him. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For in the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread and, giving thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, giving you thanks, he said the blessing. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink it, for this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity of your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis of Hope, the order of bishops, all the clergy and preparing people you became for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion and mercy, Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Jim, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in flesh those who have died, and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters, to whom all would please be with their passage in this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to join forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For see you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Christ our Lord, to whom is the world of all that is good.
To him with you and in you, O God, mighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from our evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait for blessed hope in the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church.
And gracious you grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will. Live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us all rejoice in the sign of peace. For those who are not Catholic or otherwise unable to receive for whatever reason, if you wish to remain in your pew, please feel free to do so, or step out of the pew if there's somebody that needs to go, just take a step back and leave those that wish to receive. Come forward. If you wish and cannot receive, you can just cross your arms over your chest and I will do a prayer of blessing or a spiritual being, whatever, instead. I will start with the family side, and then when everyone on this side is received, I'll simply go to this side until the casket bearers can wash it.
Please join us in our first communion hymn, number 597. I want to walk as a child of the light.
Thank you.
Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body, food for the church, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Jeremy come to be eternal people of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
God's word is saying, the Holy Assembly, funeral choir this morning for this afternoon, for helping us to join our voices in song, and together we give the sympathy to all of you. This time we will have the final accommodation here with the procession then out to the St. Edward Cemetery. As you can imagine, I'm imagining it as being a little wet and sloppy, but we'll deal with that. But if you wish not to go, for whatever reason, please feel free to go downstairs and await the return of the family and those that do go to the cemetery, where when they return, the reception will be served of sandwiches and salads and various other cookies. So, thank you for all, so please feel free to stay to go downstairs if you're not going to be part of the funeral procession. Trusting in God, we pray together for Jim Dahl to come to the last farewell. There is sadness in heart, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Jim again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in faith in Jesus Christ. Let us take our brother to his place of rest.